Good morning, children. This morning session is dedicated to class 10. BHOLI, the supplementary reader, chapter 9, BHOLI by K. Abbas. You may ask the question, sir, what does this story reveal about? Look, Indian society has always been affected by certain customs and traditions, and the social evils like dowry has always been in the root of our backwardness. We villagers and small town people always suffer from economic, you know, backwardness. That is not because of only literacy. Literacy is one of the reasons, but the social evils such as superstitions, you know, dowry, child marriages, though we have overcome these, I mean, problem to a greater extent because of the spread of education of the girls. It is rightly said that if you educate a man, you educate a citizen, but if you educate a girl, you educate the nation. So this story highlights the importance of girls' education and in transforming the perception of the society. The characters in the story are Wally itself, a girl, a young girl who is, who is the daughter of... who is among many daughters, I mean five daughters of Bishambhar, Ramlal, the man who is having daughters. Ramlal, the father of Wally, has been always prejudiced with the idea that daughters are meant for marriages only. So he's not very much encouraging the girls, his daughters, to go for attending the school. His wife is a typical, mother, and she's a typical woman. She also believes that if the girls get educated, they will have problems in their marriages. So both the father and the mother are not very, though he's a prosperous father, he's well off, he's rich, but yet he's not having consciousness for education. The school teacher plays a great role in encouraging Wally and changing her perception and making her educated. She is the inspiration behind Wally's education. Bishambhar Lal, a rich villager who is a middle-aged man, lame but rich, and he is the man who is supposed to be the husband of Wally. But later on, what happens, I'll tell in the story. And then these are the characters. So what happens that while she was 10 months old, Wally fell down from the cot and fell off the cot, and she damaged her brain. Because of that, she became a simpleton. She didn't, speak for many, 2 or 3, 4, 5 years, she couldn't speak. She became, little dull because her brain got damaged in that accident. And in addition to that, and she had, the pock marks of a smallpox. She has suffered from that. So pock marks all over her face. So she looked very ugly. Because of that, the parents, Ramlal, was very much worried about prospect of marriage. But, the village has, a new school was opened in the village. The Tahsildar, came to the village and inspected, and he told Ramlal to send his daughter to school because it was a better prospect for educating his daughters. Ramlal decided to send his daughter to school, even Wally also, because he just thought that it would be a better prospect for her. If she gets educated, she will not be a burden to the family. Now, as Wally started, initially she was reluctant in attending the schools and classes, but gradually she was inspired by her teacher, and she, she got educated. She got well educated there in the village. The village turned into town soon after some time, and there was a better prospect for everybody there. Then a prospect of marriage was, offered to her. From Bishambhar, the middle-aged man who was lame but rich. At that time, he didn't even demand for dowry. So the marriage was negotiated. And on the day of marriage, when Bishambhar saw her pockmarked face and her ugly face, he demanded 5,000 dowry, which you know, Ramlal gave also. But then also BHOLI refused because she was dead against this, I mean, dowry system. It was not that her father was not capable. See, he was capable of giving dowry. But she believed that dowry is a social evil and for that the girls have to come up. And therefore she refused to marry Bisambar and just rejected the prospect of marriage. She decided to serve her parents by teaching the same school where she was educated and serve the people and remain unmarried forever. She didn't like to marry a greedy and, you know, middle-aged lame person who was only marrying her for money. And so she decided to serve the village, rather it was a town now, and just by teaching in the same school where she was educated. So this story well narrates the change, the transformation that came in BHOLI. It was only education that really changed her perception of life, and she became capable of living and standing on her own feet. So there is an inspiration in the story that the girls must be educated so as to live an independent life, a better life. That's what I wanted to say. Thank you very much. This is Edison on the channel Easy English.